Good morning, dear colleagues. I would like to present you an analysis of the article. Subjective will be in Around the World, Trends and Predictors Across the Lifespan. This article was published in the journal Psychological Science in November 2019. Now I would like to introduce the authors of this article. Edward Diener is a professor of psychology at the University of Utah and the University of Virginia, distinguished professor at the University of Illinois, as well as a senior scientist for the Gallup organization. Andrew Jepp is leading author and doctoral student in the Department of Psychological Sciences at Purdue University. Louis Tay is an associate professor in the Industrial Organizational Psychology area at the Department of Psychological Sciences, Purdue University. The article was published in the journal Psychological Science. It is flagship journal of the Associated for Psychological Science. It has the highest rating in the field of psychology and is truly a leader in this field. Psychological science provides metrics that help provide a view of the journal's performance. The Association for Psychological Science is a signatory of DORA. The journal has impact factor 4.902. The authors of this article set the following main aim: to analyze the predictors of subjective well-being and their relationships for different ages or regions of the world. The following indicators of subjective well-being are considered: life satisfaction, positive effect, negative effect, according to the following predictors: marriage, employment, prosociality, and life meaning. This article is divided into 12 parts: title, abstract, keywords, introduction, literature review, research problem statement, methods, participants, results, discussion, conclusion, and references. The authors used the following research methods: data collection methods, survey, random digit dialing, telephone service, the interview method, the method of forward and reverse translation of the text, information processing method, the method of curvilinear interaction models. All the software code used for this article is freely available on the internet. Subjective well-being was measured in three indicators. The Contour Self-Anchoring Striving Technique was used to assess life satisfaction. Scale, which asks respondents to evaluate their current life on a ladder scale, with steps ranging from 0 worst possible life to 10 best possible life. Measures of positive and negative effect were based on items that asked if respondents had experienced particular emotions of the previous day. The emotion items were all dichotomous, the positive items being happiness, enjoyment, and smile or laugh, and the negative items being worry, sadness, stress, fear. Subjective predictors of well-being, as mentioned earlier, include 4 points: marriage, employment, prosociality, and life meaning. Marriage was measured by an item on marital status. The answers were divided into 2 categories: married or in a domestic partnership, and single, never been married, separated, divorced, or widowed. For employment, individuals indicated their employment status, which was also dichotomously distributed: unemployed, employed full-time for an employer, employing full-time for itself, employed part-time but want full-time, and employed part-time and don't want full-time. The measure of prosociality was built from 3 points of answer to the question: did the respondent commit prosocial behavior in the past month? A. Donate money to organization. B. Volunteer time for the organization. And C. Help the stranger. The definition of the variable for the life meaning was carried out by the question: do you feel your life has an important purpose or meaning? With the proposed answers: yes or no. The study involved more than 1,700,000 respondents from more than 160 countries. The average age of the participants was 40 years. The study was conducted over 11 years. The results from 167 countries cannot be generalized. Therefore, they were grouped into sets by vote regions: Anglo, Latin Europe, Germanic Europe, Nordic Europe, Eastern Europe, Latin America, Confucian Asia, Southern Asia, Arab, Sub-Saharan Africa. Let's look at the results of the study. Life satisfaction. Globally, the trend for life satisfaction was a negative curve. However, all changes were very slight, as they always stayed within 0.48 of the starting life satisfaction score at age 20. Positive effect. Globally, positive effect had a negative slope like life satisfaction over the lifespan. However, unlike satisfaction, the effects were more practically relevant. The reduction in positive effect was 0.80 at age 50 and grew to 1.32 at age 80. Negative effect. Globally, the curve across age was statistically significant, but the changes were all trivial. The maximum difference was a 0.28 increase at age 50. Marriage. Globally, for life satisfaction, there was a significant interaction between age and marriage, such that the married and slightly higher life satisfaction than the unmarried over the whole lifespan. However, the effect sizes across the lifespan were almost trivial. The largest difference was about 0.45 at age 50. Employment. The employed had higher subjective well-being than the unemployed, with differences that usually peaked at around age 50 and were lower at younger and older ages. The effect sizes were larger than seen for marriage and usually existed 1.00 by age 50. Prosocial behavior. Globally, those who engaged in prosocial behaviors had higher life satisfaction across their lifespan. But these effects were trivial in size, peaking at 0.56 by age 50. Conclusion. In general, only very small differences were found in life satisfaction and negative consequences throughout life, while the decrease in positive impact was greater. Marriage had very small association with subjective well-being, whereas employment had larger effect that peaked around age 50. Prosociality only had practically significant association with positive effect, and life meaning had strong consistent association with all subjective well-being measures across regions and ages. In all, our findings illustrate how different life priorities relate to our well-being as we age. Thanks for your attention.